Welcome to Unit 3. In Units 1 and 2, we learned about symmetric ciphers and how to use them. Symmetric ciphers assume that both parties have the same key. The important property that makes them symmetric is that the same key is used for encrypting and decrypting. In some scenarios, this is okay. When we talked about using symmetric ciphers to encrypt a file, well, we could assume that the same party is encrypting and decrypting the file so they can create and keep the key locally. But when we talk about using symmetric ciphers for most applications, that involve more than one party, this is a big problem. If Alice and Bob want to talk together, well, they have to first agree on this secret key. There has to be a way for Alice and Bob to communicate that key without exposing it. They can't send it over the insecure channel. If they could send a secret key over an insecure channel, well, they wouldn't need encryption at all. In the early days, this was done having a secret codebook that was physically distributed to the endpoints that were communicating. With Colossus, this was the codebook that had the keys for each day, and that was physically distributed to the capitals where the Lorenz machines were. With Enigma, this was physically distributed to all the ships, and captains were under very strict orders to destroy those codebooks anytime their ship was in danger of being captured. This was the most important thing to destroy on the ship to make sure the enemy didn't capture the codebook. For most applications, especially any civilian application in the day of the internet, distributing a physical codebook or having two parties meet in a secure place to exchange a key is not very practical. What we want is some way to establish a secure key or some way to enable two parties to communicate that doesn't require that. So that's the main topic of this unit. We're going to look at different ways that we could enable this kind of communication without starting from advance where Alice and Bob have a shared key.